Indian Ocean is home to one of the most active and dangerous geological faults in Asia and the world. The Sunda Megathrust is a tectonic subduction fault that has caused some of modern history's most destructive and deadly earthquakes. This area is more dangerous than the famous San Andreas fault in the US, and it could soon trigger an unprecedented mega earthquake, causing a mega tsunami larger than the 2004 Sumatra tsunami. But when and how will this event occur? Will this be the seismic event of the century? Keep watching to find out. Why is Sunda's megathrust so dangerous? The Sunda megathrust is located in the Pacific Ring of Fire, a region that surrounds the Pacific Ocean and is characterized by intense volcanic and seismic activity. It's dangerous because the Indo-Australian and Eurasian plates converge here. This creates a geological subduction fault extending approximately 5,500 kilometers from Burma to northern Australia. Encompassing a vast area moving northward at a rate of about 6 to 7 centimeters per year, the Sunda megathrust fault slowly subducts under the Eurasian plate, accumulating an enormous amount of tectonic energy. This highly dynamic subduction process generates stresses that can be suddenly released as devastating earthquakes. Because of these characteristics, earthquakes that occur on the Sunda megathrust fault are usually of extremely high magnitudes, frequently more significant than a magnitude of 8.0, making them devastating events not only locally but also in distant regions, because these earthquakes cause giant tsunamis that can travel long distances, affecting areas as far away as the coasts of East Africa. Seismic activity in this region is one of the most intense on the planet. Geological records show that the Sunda megathrust has been responsible for numerous large-scale events throughout prehistory and documented history. Scientists like Dr. Kerry Saya, renowned for his paleo-seismology and active tectonics work, have led research on prehistoric seismic events in Sumatra. Saya has been affiliated with institutions such as the California Institute of Technology, Caltech, and Nanyang Technological University, NTU, in Singapore. His studies have focused on analyzing fossil coral and coastal sediments to reconstruct the region's seismic history. One of Saya's most shocking findings was published in a 2008 Since magazine article titled "Earthquake Supercycles Inferred from Sea Level Changes Recorded in the Corals of West Sumatra." In this paper, Saya and other researchers reveal that records of relative sea level changes extracted from corals in Sumatra's Mentawai Islands indicate that this 700-kilometer-long section has generated very similar sequences of large earthquakes roughly every two centuries for at least the past 700 years. The September 2000 magnitude 8.4 earthquake is the first in a series of significant partial faults in the Mentawai section that will likely be completed in the coming decades. Seismic supercycles identified in this region have showed that although minor earthquakes relieve some stress, most build up until the fault can no longer withstand it and release all the energy in a devastating megaquake. Does it mean the Sunda megathrust will produce a new mega earthquake in the coming decades? Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Earthquake of 2004. Historically, the regions near the Indian Ocean, especially Sumatra, have suffered from numerous earthquakes followed by tsunamis. However, the 2004 one has claimed the most lives. The 2004 Indian Ocean earthquake and tsunami occurred on December 26th at 7:58 local time off the west coast of Sumatra, Indonesia. Due to its magnitude, scope, and consequences, this event is one of modern history's most devastating natural disasters. At a magnitude 9.1, it was the second most powerful earthquake recorded since the seismograph was invented. To the surprise of a few, this event originated from Sunda's megathrust. After centuries of buildup of tectonic stress culminated in a sudden slip along a 1,300-kilometer segment of the fault. This movement displaced the seabed up to 10 meters vertically, releasing an energy equivalent to 23,000 atomic bombs, like the one in Hiroshima. The seafloor displacement propelled a massive amount of water upwards, generating a tsunami with waves that reached up to 30 meters near the epicenter and moved at speeds of approximately 800 kilometers per hour. The tsunami hit the coasts of 14 countries, including Indonesia, Thailand, Sri Lanka, India, and the Maldives. However, due to its proximity, Sumatra was the most affected. The waves forcefully hit the coast, knocking down trees, houses, and small buildings, and flooding the city in a few minutes. The earthquake was so strong that the waves traveled thousands of kilometers and even reached the shores of East Africa, more than 4,000 kilometers from the earthquake's epicenter. The disaster claimed the lives of more than 227,000 people, displaced millions, and caused untold damage to infrastructure, homes, and coastal ecosystems. Indonesia was the worst-hit country, with more than 167,000 deaths, followed by Sri Lanka and India. Why was this earthquake so devastating? The reasons are several, including the affected regions were densely populated and many communities lived near the coast. In 2004, there was no early warning system for tsunamis in the Indian Ocean, leaving vulnerable communities without warning. The waves reached shores near the epicenter in minutes, leaving little time to evacuate. And finally, many communities were unaware of the signs of a tsunami, such as the water withdrawal from the coast, and therefore did not act to get to safety. The Sumatra tsunami left an indelible mark on the memory of thousands of people, being one of the worst natural disasters in modern history. The next mega earthquake in the Indian Ocean. The scientific community is concerned about the upcoming mega earthquake at the Sunda Megathrust. Although it is impossible to predict precisely when it will occur, seismological models suggest it could occur very soon, although the exact date is uncertain. As we mentioned at the beginning of this video, seismic supercycles discovered by Dr. Kerry Saya suggest that a devastating earthquake, more significant than 9, occurs approximately every 200 years. Before the 2004 earthquake, the last major earthquake on record occurred in 1833, almost 200 years ago. If the model is correct, could we expect a new super earthquake before 2033? Signs before a mega earthquake. Before a mega earthquake occurs, precursor signals could be present, although their interpretation is complicated even with modern technology. Some possible signs include 1. Increased minor seismic activity. Small earthquakes in the area could indicate that the plates are experiencing slow slip, which could eventually trigger a more significant event. 2. Terrain deformations. Geodesy studies, precise measurements of the Earth's shape, can detect subtle changes in the elevation of the terrain, suggesting stress buildup. 3. Changes in groundwater level. The pressure exerted by tectonic deformation can alter underground aquifers, causing fluctuations in water levels. However, these signals are difficult to interpret and do not guarantee an imminent earthquake. Similar events do not lead to a mega earthquake, so we should only take these signs as a possible warning. Immediate effects. A mega earthquake in the Sunda Megathrust would have devastating effects on several countries. The main effects would be Indonesia, especially Sumatra, Java, and the Mentawai Islands, where intense shocks, tsunamis, and significant geographical changes are expected. Thailand and Malaysia. The coasts of these nations would suffer devastating tsunamis. Indonesia and Sri Lanka. Tsunami waves could reach these regions within hours, causing massive flooding. Maldives. The country could be temporarily submerged due to its low altitude. The earthquake could cause up to 10 meters of displacement on the seabed, generating a tsunami with waves of 20 to 30 meters near the epicenter. This would significantly modify the coastal geography, flooding vast areas and displacing entire communities. Some low-lying islands could disappear, and coastal ecosystems would be virtually eradicated. How could we prevent or mitigate the impact? While we can't prevent megaquakes from happening, we can take steps to reduce their impact. Early warning systems. After the 2004 earthquake, Indonesia and other countries in the Indian Ocean implemented systems that detect earthquakes and tsunamis in real time. However, as seismic models improve, these systems must also continually improve. Education and preparedness. Educating the population on how to react to earthquakes and tsunamis is crucial. In the 2004 earthquake, most of the population of Sumatra did not know that a tsunami could occur after the earthquake. Simulations and drills can save lives. Resilient infrastructure. Designing buildings that can withstand earthquakes and establishing elevated shelters in tsunami-prone areas is essential. The study of mega-earthquakes and the Sunda Megathrust reminds us of the unstoppable force of nature and the urgent need to prepare future generations to face these challenges. In this context, the youngest are the hope, because they will be tomorrow's scientists, helping to build more precise seismic models and effective early warning systems. Maybe one of the subscribers of this channel might be the scientist who can predict the next mega-earthquake and make a difference by saving countless lives. In a vulnerable world, scientific knowledge and dedication represent our best hope for mitigating the impact of these natural phenomena and protecting humanity. Finally, we should mention that in the scientific community, many seismologists, geologists, and geophysicists think that the 2004 Sumatra earthquake is the corresponding earthquake for the earthquake supercycles that occur every 200 years. This means we should not expect another megathrust earthquake for another 200 years. However, the almost 30-year gap between the 2004 earthquake and the earthquake predicted by the seismic supercycles makes another group of researchers think that the corresponding earthquake for this century has not yet occurred, so it is better to be alert for the slightest sign of a large magnitude earthquake. The final bet is on 2033. If a mega earthquake does not occur in that year or the following 10 years, it would mean that the 2004 Sumatra earthquake was the corresponding mega earthquake of this century. But only time will tell. What do you think? Do you think we can expect a mega earthquake before 2033? Let us know what you think in the comments.